Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for your patience and welcome to the Catalina Bar and Grill, where we bring you nothing but the best in jazz, blues, Latin jazz, and swing. Before we start the show, we would like to ask that you please take a moment and silence your cell phones. And we also remind you there is no flash photography during the performance. And now please give a warm welcome to Sweden's Queen of Swing, Gunhild Carling.
Thank you. night, and I love to have this wonderful band by my side. You know, it's like I'm surrounded by legends, I will tell you later, and it feels very fantastic, and I'm on this legendary place. So, tonight, I composed a lot of songs, and most part of them I've never heard before. You have never heard them before. And I have, the band, they haven't heard them before either. We play them for the first time. And so we are going to record an album and of these songs. And so the first song out for tonight was Jazz Is My Lifestyle, which I composed. And I was surrounded by my family and legendary musicians. Like here and here and here, a legendary audience and everything. So the best audience I had in 3 years, actually. So next song is about if you hear the fire alarm. So what shall you bring if you hear the fire alarm? For example, you must bring the most important things you have, like pearls, perfume, love letters, of course, and the most important of it all, your 78 records with Billie Holiday. Here is a song about over this thing. Fire alarm, are you ready, guys?
Thank you.
support in the home. Can you hear me? So, we are going to play actually a song that I wrote. And the name of this song is Chanson. I wanted to sound French. But then when I wrote the arrangement, then I was interested. Well, you know, long story short, let's play.
Thank you.
get solo, Chloe. We call it Gunhild Carling Big Band, but actually all here are total legends. So I'm very proud to say it's Gunhild Carling Big Band. You know that I am, maybe you have noticed I have an accent. They haven't heard it yet. They think I'm from Florida or something. But you know, I'm from Sweden. And I have a huge family. They're big as a village. So we are so many that we actually are a whole big band. But now I'm in Los Angeles and it's band is fantastic. Okay, so we are going to play the song called You Are the Music. I composed it when I lived in Sweden, and I wanted the arrangement to be in Saminestico style. So I, now I cannot say that again. So the thing is that I was asking around on everywhere arrangers, do you know anyone who can write in Saminestico style? And they said, no, not in Sweden. You have to go to Copenhagen. So I went to Copenhagen and I found this guy, and Klaus Sørensen. He wrote this great arrangement. So now we hear it for the first time. You Are the Music! Recorder. even record it. And it was hot, 1350. And now I'm going to play popular melody, okay? A one, a two, a one, two.
Thank you.
noticed something special. You shall sing. You just sing after me.
You can come back.
Oh, yes, yeah. Maybe you would like it. arrangement is written by Michael Andrew, and he's in the audience. We are here. He will come up to scream from the audience and internet and sing a little for us.
Thank you.
sing a song? This is Michael Ann from Meine Damen und Herren.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Gunhild Carling is a student. Sensational. I don't know. If you could only increase your energy a little bit.
If we could play a little louder.
Oh, a little louder? All right, how about something by the Gershwins?
Oh, I love it.
Would that be okay?
Oh, I'm going to play trumpet on this
right now. Oh, you are?
Yes.
Okay, okay. I forgot one thing, and that is that you guys are way down here, aren't you?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
What if I go up here just for a second?
Yeah.
Three, four, one, two.
I was a stranger in the city, out of town were the people I knew. I had that feeling of self-pity. What to do, what to do, what to do. The outlook was decidedly blue. But when I walked through the forest streets alone, it turned out to be the luckiest day I know.
Astronomer, and I knew, I know, he knew and learned me inch of the ancient star chart, like the Big Dipper and, you know, stuff. And now I have written a song about Ptolemy and about space. And of course, space is endless, so this song is going to take forever. Can you start with a mystic space chord? Okay, this is the part of the show where you just say, ah. Los Angeles, they got it. In ancient Egypt lived a man, his name was Ptolemy. He claimed that Venus was lover's land, the place for musician to be. Saturn's wealthy, Mercury's healthy, he never mentioned Neptune, but he said a lot about the moon. Out of space, she rules the tide. It's also a place where only children reside. Trip to Venus, see it all alive, hear lover's melody. Let a cosmic ray light up the road to Venus along the Milky Way. It's there for you and me. Let's cruise. Oh, henchman from Camp Basie now and listen. But now I change my story. I am actually in Guinness Record Book for the only woman who plays three trumpets at the same time. Imagine if there comes in a woman here on Catalina and just plays three trumpets, then I lose my record and all my privileges and everything. So, okay, so I have to keep it tonight. Do you want to see it? We can start with the sound check, because I mean it's not only you that shall hear, also you all of it. Can you hear the trumpet now or no?
Okay. Yeah.
Talk to you. Exactly. gift of mine, and I know exactly what you are thinking about now. You think that this band swings like fantastic. You think this band is fantastic, don't you think? And that both Scotty and me look very good. And I also agree on that. Yes. But here's the thing. I know that you want to dance, and here is the chance, okay? I have composed a song because I was actually invited to the swing festival in Bangkok. And since, you know, I have been in Dancing with the Stars Sweden. And if you are any time in your life invited to Dancing with the Stars Sweden, same show as here in America, but tomorrow. So, you are not allowed to like practice dance before you enter the show, but I went to Harlem to, you know, those like Frankie Manning's son, he was like hot 1936 on Savoy Ballroom. So I was asking like, okay, what dance moves shall I know when I'm on a TV in Sweden? And he said, okay, never dance straight like this. That looks corny. You should dance weird like this. Yes, I got it. I'm thinking. So I came to this show because you know how ballroom dance is. It's like this. And I was dancing like this. And you know, the judges, they were so evil to me. They were bullying me non-stop. Which was actually a fantastic thing. Because they said, oh, you look terrible, and you cannot dance at all, and oh my God, you are horrible and everything. And people felt so pity for me and so sad for me, so they voted for me. So I placed third place. And here is the dance. So when I came to Bangkok, the organizers of the festival said, can you compose a song for our festival? And can you compose a dance for this festival? And so, the dance is like this. Can you move a little because I need space? So the first turn is like this. Keep your feet like God, we shake the Bangkok. We do it now. Catch the running man, we shake it in Bangkok. And then you do like this.
We'll be right back.
thing is, I only write about frost, ice, and snow, with a few exceptions, of course. It's a polar bear, it's cute. And I also write lyrics about falling in love in a snowstorm. And this song that we are going to sing now actually is about falling in love in a snowstorm. And winter's day.
Our two dreams meet.
today, and it's my daughter, Eden, and my son, Hugo, and my husband, Johan, and my friend, Luca Pino, and my friend, Chloe, and my friends here as well. We are going to play short now. We need a short little break in here with guest stars. This young lady just graduated from high school. And now she's playing "It Don't Mean Anything If You Didn't Get That Swing."
Thank you.
Very old medieval music, and it's gonna take 29 minutes. But But it's gonna feel much longer than that. When it comes out, will you? Actually, nowadays people don't buy CDs, so you can use this CD as a coaster, which is very good because then you have to buy 4 CDs each. So, long story, even longer now, but I shorten it a little. I was on tour with Postmodern Jukebox. started, we basically losing our voice. But then I was out of songs, and when I composed a lot of songs, California Boys, and you know, Cupertino Ragtime, and everything. And here is one of my songs that I composed, my California songs. I wait for you in San Francisco. And actually, I live there, so you are welcome. You know, my home is a speakeasy, as I was singing in the first song. And my family is a have to write a song for him. So I wrote a song, and I was like backed up by a symphony orchestra. It's much better today, as you see, and you are here. So, I mean, I had the royal family and the government and everything in front, so it's much better today. But the thing was, don't say it to anyone, but I took When the Saints Come Marching In, but I changed the words and the melody and the chords. You can still hear it when the Saints Come Marching In. But the king didn't hear it. He said, very good composition, Gunhild, you are amazing. He didn't say that, but maybe it looked like he was eventually going to say that. And now, another tip, if you're going to meet the king of Sweden, don't say you to the king, because you have to say your majesty or your highness or, you know, all these things. You cannot say you, because you will be thrown out of the castle immediately. And my father and mother, they called me, my family, and everyone called me weeks in behalf of, so remember now to not say you to the king, okay? I will remember. And then when the king came and said, ah, good composition, I was so starstruck, so I said, oh, you are fantastic. You and the queen, you are amazing, and you are my favorite king, and you, I mean, you are so unbelievable, and so were you. And the king, he looked away, and I thought, okay, maybe he's a little deaf. I say it one more time. Suddenly, it was ringing on my phone, and it was like my parents, they called, and my father said, he called and said, hey, I was watching TV right now, and you stood in TV and said you to the king 50 times. You have to leave Sweden now. You have 24 hours. You cannot show your face. His guards will come and cut off your ears. Then you have to escape, disappear, go to Denmark or to America. So I ended up here, actually. Everything turned out so well. You know, I came to Elkhart, Indiana, and there is a factory that produces trombones called King. And I knocked on their door and said, hey, yeah, we know you. You play for the king. And you said, you are a little, like, embarrassing. But we want to give poster. So I will be here and meet and greet if you want to take a photo.
Hello, everybody. We are right now in Catalina Jazz Club. We just finished up the show. And this is actually a practice show for the album that they're going to record tomorrow. I'm going to be on it, so we're going to record tomorrow. You have to buy the album when it comes out because, as you can hear, it's going to be awesome. I think that's all the information.
Did it come out? Did the video come out okay?
Yes, perfect. Thanks to you guys. So check out the album when it comes out right now. We are going to go to bed and we're going to get a full night's sleep.
So we will.
So that album can be the best that it could ever be. We love you guys. Thank you for watching.
We'll drink.
And we'll see you in Davenport, Iowa.
There will be a lot of coffee.